Hello, and welcome to Elevator Pitch Series for the Radiographer. I am Michael, and this is the second video in the series on special radiographic procedures. In this video, we'll be looking at intravenous urography. And as usual, we'll be discussing this special procedure under 11 talking points. To better understand how to perform this procedure, there are four supine projections that you should be familiar with: the AP abdomen, the AP oblique abdomen, the AP of the kidney area, and the AP of the bladder area, with a 15-degree caudal angulation. If you are not familiar with any of these projections, try to read about it in your positioning textbook before moving further in the video. That takes us to this video's discussion. Even though you can only see a blank screen, I guarantee you that I have text written on this page. Let's try darkening things up for a while. Like I said, the text 1895 has been there all along. But because it is written in white, we could not see it when the background was white. By changing the background to black, we are now able to see the white text. This effect is similar to what happens in contrast media investigations like intravenous urography. By introducing contrast media into the urinary system, pathologies that are hidden in plain X-ray investigations of the abdomen are now made visible. With that being said, intravenous urography, or IVU for short, is the radiological investigation of the urinary tract following the injection of water-soluble contrast media. The contrast media is usually injected into a vein in the arm. This is why it is called intravenous. The urinary system is made of two kidneys, which help to remove waste products from the blood, maintain a balance of the amount of fluid and electrolytes in the body, regulate the blood pressure, and excrete urine; two ureters, which help to transport urine from the kidneys to the bladder; one bladder, which acts as a reservoir for storing urine; and one urethra, which transports urine from the bladder to outside the body. Over the course of this procedure, we will make reference to different anatomical structures of the kidneys and other parts of the urinary system. You might want to brush up on your anatomy of the urinary system. That takes us to the indications for IVU. It is performed in cases of hematuria, the presence of blood in the urine, suspected cases of renal calculi, also known as kidney stones, the formation of hard mineral deposits in the kidneys, suspected transitional cell carcinoma, a cancer that affects the urinary system, suspected obstruction of the ureters, and pain in the lower sides of the back, called the flank. However, it is advised to avoid performing intravenous urography on the following set of patients: patients with suspected or confirmed renal failure. This is because it is the kidneys that excrete the contrast media that is injected in IVU. If contrast media is injected into a patient with damaged kidneys, the patient is unable to excrete the contrast media out of the body. This can lead to fatal effects of the contrast media. It is also avoided in patients suffering from multiple myeloma. This is a cancer of the plasma cells in the blood. It causes an increased amount of calcium in the blood, which affects the functioning of the kidneys. Also, a blood creatinine test is taken before an intravenous contrast media investigation. And if the blood creatinine level is greater than 200 micromoles per liter of blood, the investigation is not performed. This is because the way creatinine is excreted by the kidneys is similar to the way contrast media is excreted. If the amount of creatinine in the blood is high, it means creatinine is not being excreted out of the body, and contrast most likely also wouldn't be excreted out. Also, because of the risk of radiation damage to the unborn fetus, this examination is usually avoided in pregnant patients, unless when permission is given to go ahead in emergency cases where the patient's life is at risk. Also worthy of mention is the fact that extreme precaution must be taken when this examination is carried out on diabetic patients. That takes us to the equipment used. A conventional or digital radiography unit with an over-couch tube and bucky tray is normally used for intravenous urography. A device for compressing the abdomen is used by some departments. Also important is the intravenous cannula and the various instruments used in placing the cannula. As for contrast media, a water-soluble, preferably non-ionic contrast media with an iodine concentration of between 350 and 370 mg of iodine per milliliter is used. The average volume of contrast media administered is 50 milliliters. This, however, varies greatly with the patient's condition and size. As for patient preparation, this varies with the department's protocol and the patient's condition. The general protocol for preparing the patient for an IVU exam includes bowel preparation. The patient is instructed to observe a low-residue diet and use laxatives for 2 days prior to the exam. This ensures that the abdomen is free of feces and gases that would cause confusion when the image is viewed. Also, stomachache medicine like bismuth is radio opaque and will appear on an image of the abdomen. Next is fluid restriction. The patient is instructed to avoid taking fluids 2 or 3 hours prior to the exam. When fluids are taken, the contrast media getting to the kidneys is less concentrated. When contrast media is less concentrated, it is less visible on the image. However, fluid restriction is not observed in diabetic patients, infants, and patients with impaired renal functioning. Also, the patient is asked to urinate immediately before starting the procedure. Now, the preliminary film. The image taken before starting the procedure is an anterior-posterior view of the abdomen, taken supine and on suspended expiration. It should include an outline of both kidneys and the bladder. It is useful in checking if bowel preparation is sufficient enough for the exam to continue. It is also a useful point of reference to which subsequent images are compared. If an opacity or anomaly is seen on this image, additional views are taken to properly identify the position of these anomalies. These views include another anterior-posterior image of the abdomen, taken on suspended inspiration this time, and an anterior-posterior 35-degree oblique of each kidney. For the intravenous urography examination, the patient changes into a clean radiolucent gown and lies supine on the radiographic table. The selected volume of contrast media is then injected through a cannula placed in the median cubital vein. Immediately after this, the film sequence starts. The film sequence varies with department protocol and the patient's condition. However, this is the common film sequence. The first image is an anterior-posterior view of the kidneys, taken 10 to 14 seconds after the contrast media has been injected. It is called a nephrogram phase and as you can see, it gives a clear outline of the shape, size, and position of the kidneys. The next image is taken 5 minutes after contrast media was injected. It is also an AP view of the kidneys. This image shows contrast media being excreted from both kidneys. In departments that use compression, the compression band is applied after this view. The purpose of compression is to distend the renal pelvis and calluses, making them much more visible. However, it is very inconvenient with many radiology departments not using it today. The next image is taken 10 minutes after contrast media was injected. It is also an AP of the kidneys, and as we already said, compression of the abdomen makes the renal pelvis and calluses more visible. After this, if compression was used, it is released, and the next image is taken 20 minutes after contrast media was injected. This image is an AP of the entire abdomen. In this, the urinary system is outlined by contrast media from the kidneys to the bladder. If this image is satisfactory, the patient is asked to urinate after which an AP 15-degree caudal angulation image of the bladder is taken. In this view, the beam is centered 5 cm above the pubic symphysis. This is usually the last image of this procedure. We stated that compression is inconvenient and not used by many departments. Even in radiology departments that do use compression, there are certain situations in which compression must not be used. These include cases of suspected renal stones or masses. This is because compression can produce effects similar to a mass, causing a wrong diagnosis to be made. It is also not used in patients with suspected aneurysm of the abdominal aorta. Compression can cause an enlarged abdominal aorta to rupture, leading to death. It worsens abdominal pain and is also not advised in patients who have had a recent surgery or recently suffered trauma to the abdomen. Useful alternatives to compression include using a higher dose of contrast media and placing the patient in a Trendelenburg position, as seen on your screen. These two methods also promote distension of the renal pelvis and calluses. If the patient isn't taking any intravenous medications, the cannula is removed after the procedure and pressure applied to prevent bleeding. The patient is also advised to stay well hydrated in the coming days. This helps to flush the contrast media out of the body. Complications include contrast media reactions, especially when high doses are used or with at-risk patients. Also, a burning sensation can be felt in the arm due to the injection of the contrast media. We stated that the patient preparation and film sequence can vary with patient condition. Let us conclude by looking at a few situations and how they differ from the common protocol. First is in emergency IVU examinations. In this case, no bowel preparation or fluid restriction is performed. The examination is carried out immediately with a high dose of contrast media to compensate for the absence of fluid restriction. Secondly, in patients with renal failure. As already stated, this examination should not be carried out on these patients. However, in cases where permission has been given by the appropriate authorities to carry out the exam, the examination is carried out without fluid restriction and a high dose of contrast media. Also, delay films of up to 24 hours are taken because the failing kidneys would excrete contrast media at a much slower rate. Next is in patients with obstruction of the urinary system. In this case, delay films of up to 6 hours are taken. Next, if no kidney outline or only one kidney outline is seen during the 5-minute image of the kidneys, a full abdomen image is taken to check for the presence of ectopic kidneys. Last is in infants. To prevent dehydration, fluid restriction is not observed in infants. That concludes this video on intravenous urography. We look forward to your questions and comments in the comments section or via email. If you love this video and would want more content, please subscribe and share with your colleagues. Until next time, do enjoy the learning process and take care.